Hallo en welkom to my YouTube channel. And especially this time, because this is a bullet journal video I haven't made before. And what is all the hype around bullet journaling? Well, a lot of people are bullet journaling. And they are loving the system because there really is a system to bullet journal. But actually, I don't do very well with systems or with rules in general, especially not when creating. And for me, it is more creating an art journal, which I also use as a bullet journal. But it really isn't a real bullet journal. It actually is a journal for me. I put my to-dos in there, my weekly spreads, the things I want to do in a day, but also my appointments, but also my goals, my dreams, my wishes, the status of my videos, the status of my videos, how far I have edited them, if they are already uploaded, if they do need to do some search, etc. So it's not only appointments and to-do list, but also all my brain dump goes in there. So I wanted to show you how I use my bullet journal, and this time you will see this first will be an spread of August. I know it is already the second week of August. Next time I try to be on time. I'm always late. And in this spread you can see how I use my important dates spread, and there will be a new video with the weekly spread, so stay tuned for that. And for now, have fun bullet journaling. So here we go. As a bullet journal, I use the Leuchtturm. I'm not sure if you pronounce it correctly, but I will put a link in my video below. And as you can see, when I flip through my bullet journal, sometimes I have time to create fun pages, and I love doing that. And sometimes I don't, and I just jot things down and I don't worry too much how it looks like. And as you can see, I'm not a real neat bullet journaler. I don't use rules. So I just do what feels good to me. So I'm not following any bullet journaling rules. I just make up my own rules, and that's a fun thing, mindset to have in life. What am I using? I'm using acrylic paint from Amsterdam. I'm using a stencil. I'm using stamps. Actually, I'm using all kind of mixed media products. For the pens, I'm using Posca pens. I'm using Stazon ink. And maybe I use something else, I'm not sure. Of course, this is my paint palette and I love those bright colors. So I'm not going to take them off in a while. I'm just keep adding paint as long as it still fits on the plate. So I love the color combination of pink, yellow, orange, and some kind of reddish color. And I love Amsterdam acrylic paint for my bullet journaling the most because, I don't know how to say it, this paint just isn't really heavy. It is thin, and I'm also using a bit more of the transparent colors. As you can see, sometimes the lid gets stuck because the paint dries off, and that is because I didn't put the lid on back as I am supposed to. So that's also a pitfall when you are not that perfectionistic, because I can make a mess. For the white, I always use Liquitex, and that is heavy body white, but I'm going to use it with a sponge and with the stencil. You will see that in a few moments. For now, I'm actually checking the other side of the page because this paper is really, really, really thin, and I'm not sure if it will leak through. Of course, you don't have to use too much water. Here I was checking again if my paint wasn't going onto the other side. So just be careful with your water use and you will be totally fine using acrylic paint in your bullet journal. Of course, you can also use watercolors. I do that a lot, and that doesn't come through at all. It will only wrinkle your paper a little bit, and I'm totally fine with paper wrinkling. But I guess the real original, the OG bullet journalers do not like wrinkled papers. I'm not sure. Don't go hunt me right now, sweet people. I love everybody, if you are perfectionistic or not. I'm not sure if I'm saying that correct, but well, I don't care because I am not a perfectionist. Anyway, as you can see now, I'm just mixing up those colors. I'm really not thinking here, where am I supposed to put my color? I'm just coloring it in. So stay tuned and I will be back in a moment. This time I want to write the month in a circle and I kind of have difficulties drawing circles and I love it to be a circle. So I just used something that was on my desk and my white Posca pen always have a little bit troubles in the beginning. But as you can see now, I simply go over the line. You can see the line really softly, smoothly, but in real life I could see it clearly. So I'm just tracing my line, and after this I will be writing the name of the month, August, just by hand, and I'm adding thicker parts to the letters, and there are smaller parts. And again, with the name writing, I'm not thinking where the thicker parts or the shadow parts should be. I just go and create, and I think that is the best part of creating. Just go for it. Don't overthink it. It is only your bullet journal. It is only your to-do book or your agenda. It's not like you are selling your art or something. Just go for it. And here I'm just coloring in the letters as I feel fit. So don't overthink anything you are doing when you are being creative. Now I want to create something extra, and for this I am using a makeup brush. Yes, you can buy real expensive brushes at the art store, or sometimes you can just buy cheap brushes for makeup. And I'm just going slightly over what I just created with my white paint, and I want it to have a more smooth look. And the bubbles just don't need to be that white that they are right now. And as you can see, I'm messing up, but I'm also correcting it, creating a bigger bubble than it was in the first time because I messed it up with the makeup brush, as you could obviously see. So just keep going and don't be afraid to make mistakes, because actually you cannot make any mistake. You can cover everything up if it feels wrong to you. But just go ahead and try something new and see what happens. So this time I'm using that makeup brush to make my bubbles a little bit more smooth. To the fun part now, and I'm going to use my mixed media techniques to create this August page. As you can see, I'm using a stencil, I'm using a sponge, and I'm using white acrylic paint, and this again is the paint from Liquitex. And for stamping, I love to use the Stesson ink because it dries really quickly and it doesn't mix with paint or watercolors or anything else. So it's not soluble, if that is the correct word. So I'm just picking up my stamps and I'm just putting them randomly. Of course, I'm trying to keep them out of my circle with August, and I want there to be white dots. So this is my very old stamp I keep using to create some white dots. And as you can see, I'm not using the complete stamp. I'm only using half of it, so I can place it better than when I would use the total of the stamp. And I felt I was missing something, and I was missing my new stencil. Of course, I will put all the name of all the products I have used in beneath in the description of this video. So I think I need to add some white pen now. I love to add details with my white Posca pen. There it is. So I'm just randomly starting with the darker parts because the white will jump out more. If I would put the white Posca. If I was using the white Posca pen on the yellow paint, for example, it would not stand out as much as it does right now. And I'm just, again, not overthinking this. I'm just adding white dots here and there. And I figured I have to do something with the black flowers or the leaves. I don't know for sure what it is. It's a very old stamp. That's what I do know. I just figured it was a little bit too dark, a little bit too black. So I'm using my white Posca pen also to create more details, to bring it more to the light, actually. Thank you. there is my mixed media August important dates spread. And I almost forgot, of course, I have to fill in the dates. So you just number it from 1 to 31 in this case. And I only put in there the most important afspraak, how do you say it in English? Appointments, of course, the most important appointments or things for the day, because this is only my monthly spread, and now I'll create weekly spreads as I go, and I do that usually week before. So thank you so much for watching, and have fun creating!